right, we're here at race week 2.0, Thunder Valley in Oklahoma. Big week ahead. We're going from here through to Texas, then back up to Tulsa. We've got 2 days in Tulsa, actually, a drive day on Thursday, and then the finale back here at Thunder Valley. Now, I've got some pretty wild stuff here, as you can see, so let's go check it out.
Danny Humphreys, Midlothian, Texas. Porsche 78, Porsche 928. I've owned the car for about 22 years. Has not been down the track since I redid motor, transmission, four link, rear end, wiring, plumbing, basically everything. So I went to Frank Hawley's deal to get my license about a couple months ago. But honestly, I have never had a fast car in the quarter since 94. 572 cubic inch Steve Morris motor, made 2600 at the wheel, 35 pounds of boost. Should, by the time we get it all tuned up, should make between 2800 and 3000, I think, at the wheel. So I'm good, I'm ready. Just like I said, just gonna have fun with it and do what we do. So
have you subscribed to Sick the Mag yet? Sick the Mag is the magazine for the drag and drive community. It's kind of more like a book. If you haven't subscribed, get over to sickthemag.com, subscribe.
It started out as a 1925 Studebaker, and we wanted to build a replica rat rod of the old Munster coach. So we put a Corvette front and rear suspension under it, big block Chevrolet, and have a blast. It run 15s, but it's fun. It's not fast, but it's fun. We've run this car, this will be the second time we've run it, and I've been doing the event, well, since they started. We try to bring something different every year. So we've had a 28 Model A, a 40 Chevrolet, all kinds of stuff, but this has been the funnest one we've ever done.
My name's Scott Guthrie. I'm owner of Vets Unlimited, Crestview, Florida. Today we're going to talk about the Great Pumpkin, 1974 Corvette, 400 small block, 4L80E, AFR heads, roller cam. I bought it when I was 19 years old, stationed at Warner Robins Air Force Base. It's my beater Corvette. A lot of purists don't like it. It's kind of a rat rod of a vet, if you will. And we enjoy the drag and drive event, you know. It's just been a whole new race event, you know, instead of just going to the track on Saturday nights or whatnot. Like I said, I had it since I was 19, so there's a lot of blood, sweat, and DNA in this car. So I run the 12 second class. It's just an NA small block 400, not big horsepower, but it's fun. Running, my goal is a 12.0, you know, all week long.
Off. 509 in it with precision twin turbos. It's got a Mosher rear end. I'm really happy so far with what we've done. It is running pretty quick so far. We still got a lot more to put into it, but this week we're hoping to run low sevens, high sixes for the week as our average. We're hoping. So as long as everything works out well, that's what we plan on doing this week, and hopefully we can go faster than anybody here. I drove trucks forever, and getting in this thing is a night and day difference. We had a guy build this, the chassis on it, and it is the most smoothest thing I've ever ridden. I never could think that a race car could feel like this. Like when you're going down the track and you're going fast, it doesn't feel like it. It's really smooth. This car has taken us probably about 2 years to build and get ready. And so this is the maiden voyage, really, of getting it out here. This will be the first big race that it's been in.
Monte Carlo in the left lane, but
going, sick fans. Jason Hurley here, Rocky Mountain Race Week 2.0, Noble, Oklahoma. Running the Meltdown Firebird here again. Just went right out our personal best for the first hit, 7179, went 198.5 miles an hour, I believe. So everything's looking good. We're shaping up good so far, and hoping to keep improving. We made some upgrades for this go around. Added a second set of injectors, still running on the pump E85. Bigger fuel pump, O-ring the heads, went to copper head gaskets so we can push that boost higher, and hopefully we'll see 40 pounds of boost this week, and hopefully 200 miles an hour and into the sixes.
also thank you, Nation, for the Winter Shake Award.
Diff fixed.
Yeah, it broke spider gears inside there. So I pulled up to the starting line and got on the two-step and it just snapped. So it didn't even go 13 feet. We was hoping it was the pin that goes in between the spider gears. We was hoping it was broke, but it turns out it was the spider because we was gonna have it welded up, but it wasn't the pin, it was the spider gear. So we gotta change the whole third member. But I don't got one here, it's at the house, so we're out till then. We just kind of missed one day, but it'll be all right.
So we're swapping the transmission out, but it's not that bad. It's kind of common for us.
Right, really?
You make as much power and you weigh this much, it's just part of the game. It's commonplace making, you know, 2,500 horsepower and weighing 6,000 pounds or 6,400 pounds trying to go down the racetracks hard. So I made a mistake and nitrous came on in first gear. 136 jet came on in first gear. And you just can't do that. And it was my fault. So now I just got to go in there and change it a little bit, you know, after we fix it. So we'll be back.
Broken rods, pistons.
Oh my.
Boost just, it overboosted and blew it up. So we, a nice fellow was kind enough to heard our plea on the Facebook page and said he might have a block for us, so that's the one over there. And we're swapping parts, the good to the new. Hopefully we can bring it back to life. continue on.
All right, day one, race week 2.0 here at Thunder Valley in Oklahoma. We're all wrapped up for tonight, so seen some good runs today. Jason Hurley, 710, leads the way. So a good night for him. Not so good for some others. It's going to be a late night for these guys. We get on the road tomorrow morning, heading to Texas Motorplex for day two. So we'll see you guys then.